Skills are non-transferable. Intruders on campus. You know what to do. Issues should go to the health clinic. Needed to unlock toilets. Lovely.
Sir Nigel Bickleworth on Two Point Radio.
Hello, hello. Today we're discussing, for the very first time, ironically, sequels. Yes, that's right. When the wicked and wretched behind something decide that it's a good idea to bless us all once again with the second pressing of their already tenuous idea.
Janitor is needed to collect litter.
Thank you.
astrology department has published fresh horoscopes. Another bad one for me. Janitor required in bathroom.
Sequelization, or the art of doing something again, is derived from the Greek word sequalid, meaning lazy, repetitive, or in some way redundant. It would seem that the ancients are trying to tell you something, ambitionless auteurs of our times.
Janitor to install upgrade, please. To the library. Thank you. Approaching the end of the academic year. Try not to worry. Thank you. Pastoral issues can be remedied by talking to a qualified librarian.
Sequelization. Doing something again. Wait, no, we've covered that. See what I did there? I almost repeated myself and then decided not to. It is possible. Up next. Something fresh.
Students eating rubbish are reminded that you are what you eat. Thank you. enjoy your summer. I know I will. Starting soon. Was there anything we wanted to do? Healthy body, healthy mind. I came up with that.
Hi, I'm Jumbo McNally, and at Jumbo University, every instructor is handpicked by someone that was handpicked by someone that I handpicked. That's the Jumbo Touch. Jumbo University, be your biggest self.
Thank you. To fix Omnicure. body is a temple, and you wouldn't fill a temple with crisps.
Repetition seems to me to be at the heart of all of our cultural and social failings. Oh, what comfort you all seem to take in your cookie-cutter days. Another weekend, another roach burger, another glorified re-release at the picture theatre. Come on, people, go out there and live! Join me tomorrow on 2 Point Radio, where I'll be talking about my collection of ceramic vows.
Taking students for cosmic expansion. The timetable is not written in stone. Still, we're not changing it.
Many of you are getting in touch about one particular sequel. Yes, the follow-up to Mr. Cushion's positively poisonous production, Perilous Spandex. The only thing hazardous about that particular picture is watching it. The sequel, entitled perilous spandex too, the Handles of Love received the coveted Piece of Garbage Award. A little award that I bestow to highlight, as a public service announcement really, those films most bereft of value in our county's rich tradition of abominable filmmaking. This has been exhausting. We shan't be doing it again, because unlike all you reproduction-peddling, washed-up rehash monkeys, we, at Two Point Radio, know when to stop.
Sci-fi convention, starting now. Good for them. Required in Rocket Lab. Intruders on campus. You know what to do. Thank you. students are reminded that you don't have to ask to go to the toilet.
That's the show. Of course, this has all been delivered to you with one rather heavy caveat. If I were ever to be involved in a second rendition of anything, I can be certain in telling you that it would be for good reason. And, if anything, would surely be a bigger, better, Bickle-worthier version of what had come before it. How was that? Little Ryan?
Education is non-refundable. The campus is not responsible for meteors or any other celestial shrapnel. Thank you. Interfere with your studies. Go to the nurse and get back to work. Janitor required to install upgrade.
Mm-hmm.
assistant needed in medical office.
Hello, yes, I'm Maggie Watmore, doing my best on campus radio. We've got a big show for you today, but I'm trying not to think about it. No, only joking, of course. This is really fun. Let's have some music, shall we? Over to you, and something about a hose.
Yes, that's right. Students were protesting a sudden spike in milkshake prices. I'm told that proceedings were fairly peaceful until a rogue beach ball struck an attendant on the arm. Things got a little tasty, and the garden hose was even used on one student who described himself as fine, just a bit wet. I'll be here bringing you the updates as the story develops. Back to you.
It doesn't matter how desperate you are. No urinating on campus facilities. Student Union requires an assistant. Healthy body, healthy mind. I came up with that.
And now, Wanda, with an update on the latest campus fashion trends. Anyone who's someone is wearing their shoelaces untied. This trend is here to stay. Oh, there really is something about seeing all those laces dancing in the wind. Yes, we may have seen a fairly drastic uptake in people falling down, but this is the price you pay for fashion.
It doesn't matter how desperate you are. No urinating on campus facilities.
Thank you.
Campus intruders, please not come in. Questions. You can find the bathroom yourself. I believe in you.
Hi, I'm Jumbo McNally, and at Jumbo University, every instructor is handpicked by someone that was handpicked by someone that I handpicked. That's the Jumbo touch. Jumbo University, be your biggest self.
Assistant to the library. Thank you. Some students have a long way to travel. Is that their problem or ours? attention. Your finger is not a toothbrush.
We've come to the end of today's show, and didn't that fly by? I wasn't timing it or anything, but if I was, I think I'd see that we finished 35 seconds early. I've been Maggie Watmore. I'll be back tomorrow for my next allotted segment. Bye for now.
Starting in the Student Union. Be warned. Assistant to the library. Thank you. To install upgrade, please. Announcement. Healthy body, healthy mind. I came up with that.
Sir Nigel Bickleworth on 2 Point Radio. Welcome to 2 Point Radio, where it's a great day. Why? Because I, Sir Nigel Bickleworth, am talking into a microphone. Can you feel it? Can you hear me? Is this thing on? Really, Dennis, if this is off again, I'm going to come in there and dunk you like a biscuit. We'll check that I'm on the air and be back with more sumptuous sound wave salaciousness after this.
Thank you.
Why is it that the youth of today believe they can churn out a radio show from the comfort of their toilet seats? The gall! In my day, one had to work for years making sandwiches and polishing the communication tower before they even let you touch a microphone. There's more to radio than ability, charm, and technological literacy. Eager little autodidacts, the lot of them.
It's almost the end of the academic year, in case you hadn't noticed. Results published. Now. Enjoy your summer. I know I will.
My darling, albeit slack-jawed, nephew Kevin ushered me through cyberspace and into the world of video games. Yes, I played the latest entry in the popular Meat Wizard franchise for Sir Nigel Reviews. I was lost. I was cold. I was scared. The controller was sticky and the subject matter obscene. While I'm unsurprised that it appeals to the desensitized youth of today, I'll tell you what I told that chap at the deli. No one needs that much ham. One magical gem out of a possible five. New to the Crumley Student Range, instant casserole. You want a warming meal, but you've not got all day.
Come on!
With Crumley's new instant casserole range, you just add water, and you've got something a lot like casserole. Just like Mama used to make.
that are needed to unblock toilets. Lovely.
To the news and the controversies surrounding Education Minister Tarquin Foxbridge, who allegedly blew his nose on official government documents. Stories like this are scandalous. It's perfectly clear to me that a group of students have fabricated the images somehow, and yet this poor minister faces all manner of backlash and public murmurings. And why? Because he was photographed doing something? I know a witch hunt when I see one.
Issues can be remedied by talking to a qualified librarian. Intruders on campus. Oh no.